Four.
The bite was a 17.
All right, that's decent.
Yeah, the lowest roll there was a 12.
Yeah,
that's just silly.
Also, one of the things, of course, I get loads of bonuses for being in the air, of which we're doing sky combat.
Smack, smack, crack.
Which I have a feeling we're going to be doing more of as time goes along, not less.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the thing was, basically, because you guys get bonuses against dragons, I get bonuses against flying creatures flat.
If you're nauseated, can you still take immediate actions?
Immediate?
You can take one move action per round.
Does it say anything of swift actions, is the question.
I think it just says, hey, let me peel up the text.
Because swift actions is the equivalent of an immediate action.
Nauseated. I think it appears you have to spell.
Os called bra.
For now, I'd say it's fair to assume that yes, because
actually, I have it up now.
Okay.
Nauseated. Creatures with nauseated, constricted, blah blah blah, flavor. They are unable to attack, cast spells, concentrate spells, or do anything else requiring any attention. The only action such a carry can take is a single move action per round.
Okay, probably not then.
Nothing that requires any attention. This is the key.
So if it's spell casting,
I guess that's up to. Well, that's specially named in there, but like
what he wanted to try would have definitely required attention. Those are all hits against the bird. The crit does not confirm.
Oh, how much did it take to kill the bird? Or
it's not enough to kill him.
No,
I think
probably like an animal companion thing.
Oh, yeah,
never mind.
It looks like enough.
That's enough.
Was it just enough to kill the bird? Or
it was just enough.
Okay, so he falls and takes 66 points of falling damage.
He certainly does fall.
No, if we could, we would high-five Dart, but you know.
Hey, wait.
That's dangerous right now.
We should skin the bird.
Five foot fly forward. We're now in reach of each other.
High-five.
I'll play fly check.
Well, high face, right? Face can reach.
I will also move up 5 feet to 70 feet.
Are you saying you want a nose touch? Is that what you're saying?
Headbutting.
Do you want a nose touch?
Does he do like a ride check to not fall, like to not take
he,
like
he can't.
An extra d6?
He can't.
Okay.
But yeah, the ride check to not take the extra d6, he can't really fail.
Okay.
Also, he's falling from the sky. He doesn't apply here.
Yeah.
But yeah, he sure does not have acrobatics to negate.
I was thinking maybe you fall prone when you fall from the sky, but I honestly don't know.
Also, she technically, I probably should agree to ignore intentional fall damage.
This seeker will shoot at two looks easier to hit. Avonix looks hard.
True.
Oh, so let's go for that.
Maybe you should come up here.
No. Taraxis.
It's like basketball. You set him up and slam him down.
Mm-hmm. Well, hi. I am here to make your life miserable.
Little girl.
That's a mess.
Never mind. I'm here to annoy you, mildly.
this guy can... He can charge you, so he will.
Hey, come back, you beast!
I had to remove the ice because the ice runs out now.
She will not attack.
At the end of next turn, when I will lose my spiritual weapons.
No.
I'd like to add now, if you want to talk to the people, he can't really do much because he's puking.
But yeah, I guess talking requires attention. But you know, we're going to defeat them, and then we're going to basically tell them that, well, game's up, right?
And they just literally to fall from the sky, so.
Yeah. Land on his feet, though. Look up. Like, well, I will start with the spiritual weapon against her. As it happens. All right.
That's a hit.
Yes, 3 force damage. Take it. Then I'll send the other one against John D's BF out of 5, because why not? Get some use out of it. Look at that.
Spear Fighter 5? Where is he? There he is.
He's that guy.
That's a fight.
Smack. And then the Seeker is going to get shot.
From the darkness, arrows fly. Uh-huh. The rain of
it's
death.
Rain from the sky, you know? It's good that she's learning this kind of thing.
Against Flatfooted, that's also it.
Damage isn't great. I've got to admit that. But
you know, she'll learn.
The whole thing about not having a composite bow, it's not being able to use one.
Really. The Inquisitor is, I mean,
puking on the floor.
Yeah. Can take a move action, which is not enough to do anything. He can't do anything.
He could kneel. That's why he's a legion.
He does not kneel. He tries to look as imperious as before. This archer will shoot at Tyrexus. And not roll a 20.
Who's your god now?
Idavox.
Your god is a lie!
Well, I'll charge him from up here then. So I'll move. I'll still say it. Might as well. Yeah, well, it's a charge, so it will be.
10 feet in the air.
Yeah.
A vertical charge.
Oh. That's the one that really gets momentum.
That's a mess.
With the wings just...
Did you have the charge modifier in there?
She does have the shield did.
On her. That only applies the penalty, not the bonus.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, with the charge, which you did not apply to that, that would be a hit.
Oh. Then you... No.
Because the button is charge, lunge, cleave, which is just things that remove AC.
Of course.
And the 9 points of damage are enough to make the Inquisitor drop unconscious.
Oh, okay. You just don't want to roll, is that it?
It was enough to make him drop unconscious.
You might get more strength damage.
Yeah.
Do you want me to roll Fortitude saves?
Yes.
Yeah, have some Fortitude saves.
Uh-huh.
Have all of them.
Is that on his turn he actually had to do them himself as well, because, you know, it's already
used
a few times, so...
Well, there's 3 saves and he made all of them.
Tina, that's something you should remember, that when they get poisoned, they have to keep making saves.
True.
Or get more poisoned.
Against Tyrexus? No. This guy, against Tyrexus. Wait, are you an archer? Yes. No. Avonix.
So, do we just want to clean up all the remaining standing ones, or should I just go for like the Seeker Guide, or
knock down the Seeker Guide? I'll try talking to them.
I'm pretty bad wounded, actually, admittedly, very badly wounded.
Well, you can come up here then.
You know, that's actually not the worst idea, because I one shot from the Seeker Guide, I could fall.
You'll have to withdraw to get up here, but that's probably fine.
You know, I can spiral fly up to you.
Draw from into the darkness.
Yes, into the darkness I fly. Receiving my minus one.
Well, when you come back fully healed, wouldn't it?
my minus one to AC for now being next to you. However, fly check.
Sure. Well, moving back doesn't do anything for her, so she's just going to shoot Tyrexus in the face. Hopefully. She hopes.
Point blank?
At point blank, yes. But as it turns out, having a dragon right in front of you is not good for morale. That's
it's
a hit.
Distracting.
Tyrexus.
Wait. Additional 3. It's just crackling everywhere. Well, let's murder it. John Wayne.
Those are all hits.
Well, as soon as it kills, I'm going to 5-foot step up here and continue to slaughter this guy.
The first claw is enough to kill her.
Okay. Then we have 12, 23 on the spear fighter.
Not quite enough, but close.
Yep.
The spear fighter here will then try to stab you again. He's not charging this time. will take a 5-foot step before that, otherwise he can't hit you, but yeah. Attacks.
What happened to all the dudes by the camels?
They ran away.
Okay, into the desert.
Yes.
I mean, I guess that was not much rational thought, but...
They didn't bring the camels?
I mean, they just woke up like, oh, fuck, oh, shit.
The camels are attached to a pole, and they are doing their best to follow the guides into the desert, but not really managing to break themselves free.
You know. I guess I should.
Those poor scared camels. Look at them, they look so happy. Like, hello.
I always think of Sif when I see that cat.
There you go.
Ah, that's so nice.
And Evendra will like to use the wand, which I guess she'll have to use like a used magic device.
Yes.
Sif looks like that cat when you try to take her outside.
Yes. Where's the use
magic? Nature! No!
It should be a skill.
It's a skill check user.
I think look for it on the list, but I don't see it.
It'll be at the bottom if it's loaded properly.
There's no spell called use magic device. What?
There is.
But not in the skill checklist.
Have you put skill points into it?
Yes.
Because it needs skill points loaded in for it to appear.
Are they set up correctly then?
Let me fix that. Use magic device. No, it's not.
Oh.
Charisma, she has 5 ranks in it. She does not get a bonus.
That's pretty good. No, is she charisma, level 5?
She is level 5.
Mm. Okay, now you can roll it.
She's this wonder kid, isn't she?
She is. She's been taught by the best. Some would say. I still can't
hashtag
see it.
False
modesty. You'll have to do it, sheep. I can't see it.
Well, I'm just going to roll it manually.
Hashtag the 1%.
5 plus 3. That's a success.
Mm-hmm. Yep, then you can get the, like, 1d8.
Mm-hmm. She's the fairy godmother of the dragons. She bippity bobbity boops you.
How many charges did the one we gave her have?
Can we make it that she does?
I don't know. I erased it from my inventory, and I gave it to you.
Right.
There wasn't many...
But how many did it have, then?
I think it was 5 or something like that.
5 charges?
Right. I think it was something like that.
Sure,
I mean, pretty sure we had 2 wands, didn't we?
Yeah, you had 2 wands. Yeah. I gave you 1. I think you had...
The one would have been empty. One would have been empty. The other one would have been 4, so...
There wasn't many left. I think it was
around
5.
There wasn't many left. No, it was more
than
5.
If you say 5, I'll believe 5.
It was closer to around 20, I think. Lower, a bit lower? In the teens.
I don't think it was 20. It wasn't that much. I remember thinking, whoa. So,
for now, I'm just going to say 5.
While you're discussing this, this archer has tried to attack Terexus.
No, I wanted to talk.
Terribly. Talk now, then.
Your false leader has fallen. You have no chance of winning. Why fight your own clan? The Moon Clan calls strong warriors such as yourself back. Does this not show that we of the Moon Clan have defeated the Lords of Civilization and the champion that they sent?
Roll me a diplomacy check.
Sure. The Moon Clan's ways are not gone. And now both sides have dragons. It's
19. Your words certainly make the people pause, as from one of the tents steps back a person steps out a person who seems rather unimpressed by this whole carnage going on. His bulky frame slowly going through the tent entrance, arms crossed, as he frowns at you, and eventually does shout, "The Moon Clan's ways might not be gone, but the Moon Clan is. Your presence here does not change that. In fact, you've only accelerated the fact." She points at one of the bodies. "You may have killed that pesky who calls himself Inquisitor, who poisoned our ways by suggesting that our ways are wrong, but how are you going to change anything?"
"Your men are not dead. See to them, and they can survive. Do so now, and I will help you. But stop this fighting. We did not come here to fight. We came here to talk."
He hesitates for a moment and will then essentially order the few Chandios still left fighting here to take care of the wounded, expecting his commands to get carried out, and sure enough, they are, as they stop fighting you, at least. They don't drop their weapons.
We only
keep
beat
them.
Down two of them, so...
Yeah, that's true, but still.
True.
They don't drop their weapon, they certainly keep them, sometimes kind of pointing them in your direction, but they seem to agree with their commands of what you might guess is their chieftain, former chieftain, perhaps.
I know. Imagine the image, by the way, where he is shouting into the heavens.
Where booming voice returns. And the giggle of a little girl.
Yeah, you better surrender or we kill all of you. It's like,
thanks, Dark.
So, well, I guess that's combat over, right? So we should go and,
let's
like...
loot.
Well, I mean, let's land loot. First and talk to him. But we can't just begin looting now.
Of course we can.
I mean, those are magical bows. I can.
You
I
know
can
what? You're
not serious, right?
I am totally serious. You're going to talk to him. I'll get the loot.
He is a blue dragon. He does like shiny stuff.
Mm-hmm. All right, sure.
I can be by your side if you want and look
no,
scary.
No, it's fine. Go and act like uncivilized beasts. Sure, they will love it.
Don't be so.
I guess we should lower our elevation from 150 feet.
Yeah, definitely. Guy's gonna land. He doesn't want to stick.
Yeah, I know he's gonna land.
It's here to talk, after all.
With that charge. I'm gonna attack, but not. I'm not gonna attack anyone. I just want to remove the charge.
Okay.
Land. Spread wings.
There we go.
Look at the man. Look at them and say. Do they need magical attention? You look to them. The Shwanti.
He looks over to the wounded ones, back to you, and says, if they don't make it, then they weren't supposed to make it. Sure, you can fix your mistakes with magic, but that's not going to change what happened to the Moon Clan now, is it?
Yes. Well, in the long run, it is. You are far from the last... or far from the first splinter faction we have picked up. Many are returning to the Moon Clan, realizing that there now is a chance to win this fight against Surta.
You're not only talking to a splinter faction, as you call it, you're talking to a splintered splinter faction. Half my riders left for Kermaga to join the civilized life, whatever that might mean. The other half doubt every command I give because of those Inquisitor's honeyed words.
Says, I have a rather honey tongue myself, if that is what you require. Smiles. Beyond that, we ask only that you take a trip back to the Moon Clan to see what things look like now compared to when you left. I'm sure that alone will be able to, well, perhaps that and the tales they might tell of the victories we have won might convince them. Still, you certainly don't seem to have been convinced by this Inquisitor.
Certainly not. The things he has said are simply too good to be true, and I believe that they are indeed too good. Civilization, we've had our encounters with them, caravans and merchants coming up here. It wouldn't be a life for me.
I believe you once your people lived in the lowlands. It certainly is a honeyed promise, but also a promise of working for these kinds of men, instead of enjoying the freedom that these plains and Badlands might promise, harsh as they are.
Would certainly be a nice thought to combine our freedom up here with the riches down below.
Let's defeat Sunta first, and then we'll see about it. Okay, I'll give him a sort of a draconic smile.
You seem very convinced of yourself, considering that you are the size of a foot of one of Sunta's bigger beasts.
Says, well, one of those bigger beasts' corpse is right now resting inside the sacred valley of the Moon Clan. We spoke to the spirit there, and it had great things in promise for us. We left secrets, and, well, the Clan Chieftain was most happy about our defeat of the Sun Clan camp and the servants the Sun Clan sent for in retribution. Dragons such as us. Bigger than us, but far less cunning, and far less magically potent. Some that I beg grow foolish in their arrogance.
Kind of, he smiles at that sentence or at that statement. You certainly sound like you've collected many successes. However, picking off the odd straggler is hardly a big accomplishment, as big as you might have been. You talk about going against the Sun Clan, the entirety of the Sun Clan, who has been more than even to the Moon Clan, even in our best of times. In addition to that, rumors range from half a dozen dragons to hundreds of them.
They will be occupied elsewhere. Regardless, we will not only have the Moon Clan. There are other clans who are threatened or even engaged with the Sun Clan even now. They do not put their attention to us because they think us broken. In that time we will rally while they kill themselves against the walls of the Skull Clan, whom we plan to perhaps join up with in a pincer attack. We have not yet spoken to the famed strategist, but once he joins our ranks, I'm sure he will have ideas.
Roll me a diplomacy check.
Sure.
He nods, says, as far as I'm aware, there's only three options I have here. Ignore everything that happened and try to live life as I've always had. In a time where that is really inappropriate, considering that half the Moon Clan is gone and half of my clan here is gone. The second option would be to do as the Inquisitor said, to head down below into Kaer Maga through that passageway he organized, talk to his people so that we can get assigned jobs and other things to learn the more civilized ways. It sounds like hell to me. And the third option apparently is you.
Guys, nods. I do believe we have a better option. We ask you not to work for us, not to serve us. We ask simply that you live as you have always lived and do not give up that way, that you live to fight those who would try to control and oppress you, like we do.
It's quite easy, isn't it? As you said yourself, on the one hand you have hell, and on the other hand you have an opportunity to reclaim your great destiny. The choice is rather obvious, is it not?
Your words are at least as honeyed as that of the Inquisitor. However, if there's a splinter of truth to them, then I'm willing to take that chance, I suppose.
All we ask is that you go and see for yourself. We'll not tell you what you should do. We'll tell you how things are, at least in our eyes. Perhaps your eyes will see different when you get to the camp.
He nods. I have lost many fighters and riders. To the Sun Clan, to their attacks, to the Inquisitor's words. But some of them still remain, and I still have some of my horses, at least. He points at a group of horses who, this entire fight, have been severely unimpressed by all that's happened.
Seen before, been there.
Even from a distance, you can see that they are massive beasts. They are essentially like the horses you've seen perhaps in Pylee's Tower in the stables. However, they are probably twice as big and composed entirely out of muscle. Their tails are short, to say the least, stubby things showing marks of scorch marks, essentially. Not something intentional, however, something that might very well happen if you got too close to one of the ember storms that you have yet to experience.
Mm-hmm.
And it is quite obvious that Gelstack, the chieftain here, is very proud of them. He will also introduce himself, of course, to you, and then say, if you wish for me to collect my people here and head to the Cave of Scrolls, then I suppose I will do so. There's no reason why we should stay here. We cannot train our horses in peace if they are just to get slaughtered by whatever happens to pass by. Perhaps it is time to use their training in proper combat for a change.
Yes, they were certainly said that your horses reflected the courage of your men here. So it looks over at them. And I can see that seems to be true.
My men reflect the courage of my horses.
You look at the horses and say, well, that seems to be quite a compliment to them. They seem thoroughly unimpressed by our presence. That's something we're used to, but something that will be very good in the fights to come.
What kind of fights are you looking for, then? It would be very unwise to attack the entirety of the Sun Clan in a frontal assault.
First we will rally, then we will gather up the most prominent people. So it looks at him for a little time. And says, and then we will all together make a plan. We are not the commanders of this here thing. We simply help it along.
You know it.
Well, you should gather your clan and the men you have left and set out then, Chieftain.
I will do so immediately, then. It is growing dark, however, riding at night is much more comfortable anyways.
Very good, then.
I can actually look down to the camels and say, what about those traitors, or what were they? What were they doing here?
They were the desert. They were workers working for the Inquisitor, doing his laundry and carrying around his boxes and luggage.
Mm-hmm.
They likely ran off into the desert. They are unlikely to ever find their way back to anything.
We should
take a look at that luggage.
Mm-hmm. I have extracted his whole sort of sack. He has gathered all the equipment from...
I found his tent.
from all of the people that fell in the battle and probably went into his tent and took his stuff as well. He hasn't gone through the luggage, but we can do that as well.
We should probably bring the camels then. They might be good for beasts of burden. They don't seem fit for fighting.
You know, maybe he should use them with the wounded.
Maybe, yeah.
As for loot, you get the following. I will leave out the things I would consider unimportant for you, like the mundane equipment.
Sure.
3 masterwork chain shirts.
Just opening the document here. Alright. Every chain shirt. 3 of those.
3 heavy crossbows plus 1.
Crossbow plus 1. Yep.
A long spear plus 1.
Yep.
A light crossbow plus 1. A mithril chain shirt plus 1. And mithril hippogriff chain shirt barding.
Mithril Lodge chain shirt barding.
Can we flay the hippogriff?
I can't.
Except someone.
Do you want it?
Look at his clothes. I kinda do, yeah.
I could make like whatever its name was, like it could mean the zombie hippogriff, like that.
I kind of just wanted a trophy because it was such a splendid, you know, hippogriff.
I bet its skull would make a pretty badass helmet.
I suppose so.
Go for it. Sure. I think you'll grow out of it rather quickly.
No, I'm not going to have it on my helmet. I'm going to have it on my pile. In
sure.
My you can have it on your shoulder or something. That would be cool.
like a Mad Max raider has to have it on my shoulder.
No, you never even touch the creature.
You imitate Tiamat by putting 4 heads on his
shoulders.
Rawr! Hippogriff head, a ram's head.
Sure, Tiraxus will get the skull from the hippogriff.
But it is kind of hilarious that you weren't even in the fight with it.
Only me and Einhorn actually hit it. I most
Well, you know, first come, first serve.
Uh-huh.
Well, the next one.
Einarvax is not a fan of trophies. The only reason she has the stinger of that Viren was because of the chase, because he annoyed her so much. It's basically a never again.
In the luggage of the Inquisitor, you find a whole lot of things that might be useful, but not really valuable. In addition to that, collecting all the different trinkets that might not all have belonged to the Inquisitor, but some of them to the Seekers and the Workers, you get a total count of valuables around 2,000 gold pieces. Certainly most of it from the Inquisitor, as he seems to be rather fond of carrying around trade goods mostly, like paper, which is somewhat rare in these parts.
Oh, paper.
No. Paper.
Trade goods.
I've never seen paper. If I don't want to see in the water world.
Good. I mean, that went well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'd like to think.
It did.
Nice pile of goodies. We got what remains of the clan moving.
Mm-hmm.
And now we can go and visit the general and basically be in a position of strength.
Is he the last guy?
Yes.
I guess this kind of dealt with two people at once, didn't it?
Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Unless we want to go back to the tomb of the first white and try to recruit the ghost guy.
I don't know. I think
he's not a ghost.
I don't think he'll fight with us.
No, I don't think so either.
He's only there to revive that one.
He's like a dragon druid type mad hermit dude.
Definitely mad hermit dude.
Mm-hmm. The dragons are speaking to me. You're like, yes, of course, old man. All is very clear to me now.
Volnix did say he got a feeling from that skull as well, so it can be random.
I mean, of course it
that
is.
That there are two white dragons that were attracted to it.
Weird to sell. So we have a mithril hippogriff of parting.
It's very special. But I bet in Kermaga there is someone who wants that. Or in Corvosa.
I need that. I just don't ask.
Exactly. It's
well,
the
you
thing
know,
I'm doing. It's
smelled it down.
All right.
I don't think it matters what it used to be, but that it's what it's worth.
It's not strange, is it? And we're like, no. It's fine.
Could it have been from a horse?
Yes, a horse. That's what I meant. All right. Let's. we have a nice pile. We should go to the general.
Yeah, among the Inquisitor's valuables, you also find a holy symbol, and it is easy enough to recognize as the one from Abada.
Yes.
Hence the hippogriff's name.
Yes, hence the hippogriff's name, yeah.
Parting, though, that's the real stuff.
I'm curious if it was the real Cobblehoof.
I mean, you could roll me a religion check.
Sure.
To see if it was indeed the herald of one of the gods.
Yes, because that's what I recognize it from.
A Cobblehoof herald?
Yeah, the herald of Abadar is an hippogriff named Cobblehoof.
He probably just named it after.
Which is why I saw it. It was like, uh-oh, that could be real fucking bad. Is it really the herald?
Araxes would think that this random hippogriff is just a random hippogriff and not actually the herald of a god.
He nods sagely. Yes, of course.
Oh,
if it was, then you are far stronger than you would have anticipated.
Yeah, I was also surprised. You know, I was like, wow, I'm much stronger. It didn't have as good.
Brent's not really surprised. More like
good saves as I thought it would.
Yeah, his saves weren't that
poison.
Good.
Yeah, oof.
Didn't think gods were susceptible, but.
Yeah, well.
Alright.
It's a bit pretentious to name your hippogriff after,
Maybe he just did.
Something to aspire to,
I guess.
Yeah, maybe he just was really bad at names.
Yes. Like, I can't come up with a name for my... Fuck it, I'll take Jesus. You know, that's... Jesus the Hippogriff.
But more like Moses, right?
Moses the Hippogriff.
Some people.
I am God and this is my horse, Jesus.
God and Jesus is the same person, as far as I understand.
I named my cat after Forrest's wife. Not saying it's the same, though. Totally not the same.
Totally married to a cat.
Poor, but totally.
Oh boy.
Regardless,
it is not illegal in Denmark. I've heard.
It is now.
Yeah. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Great sadness all over.
Yes. All the pig farmers are. much sad. Was it similar?
You may move yourselves back to the map. It is currently night, and you haven't rested yet.
Let's rest.
Let's sleep in one of these tents. How about? Well, actually, it's night. So let's fly at night instead.
Okay.
Well, you haven't rested yet, so.
Well,
we
didn't rest at all. But we didn't fly at day, right? We flew at night. I thought.
That's true. Yeah.
So it's like becoming day now, right? Like morning, kind of.
We were attacking in the night, so we can press on maybe one or two hexes before it breaks.
Yeah, I guess it would be getting morning now. That's true.
Okay.
So we want to, like, get to some place where we can sleep without being grilled.
Mm-hmm.
That would be pretty sweet.
We have a tent with us, I mean.
I do have a tent, yeah.
We can cover us in a tarp. Sure. Is there, like, you have the map of the oases. Is there, like, one nearby here? Sort of. Anywhere within two squares of this thing.
There would be one to the east where the Inquisitor had his camp.
Oh, let's go there then. That's probably nice.
Okay. Yeah.
You just hang out, you know, then we can use the other night to fly there and get there again in the morning. That's
all right. Good, let's hang out at the oasis. It is time to frolic.
Well, more like time to go there and like not be cooked.
I hope you brought your swimsuits.
Let me give you an oasis.
Everyone looks really confused. Swimsuit?
Yes, when, I mean...
Oh, Evandra?
I mean, you wouldn't go, you know.
Would you go without? I mean...
All right.
I guess I've heard that greens are very liberal, but
you know, Einarvox will just.
Everyone blushes and like turns tomato red.
Don't Google dragon in a swimsuit. You are going to get results.
I remember we did
like
that.
I like how there was like a little swimsuit. Waiting pause, as if you did it. Sheep. Will there? No. Oh, yeah.
Swimsuit don't dragon. You remember he sent a picture?
Let's not go.
That's not.
Let's just go to the. Don't just don't. Let's just go to the. See, now we have an oasis. Oh.
You fly towards the oasis that you have visited essentially just the day before, still showing signs of recent human habitation. And as you arrive close to there, at least, the sun has certainly come up, peeking over the horizon. And I would like you to roll me perception checks.
The sun is red.
Why did
my token is gone.
No, we're at the oasis, guys.
You're at the oasis.
Well, like,
I didn't see you while you took us.
Ah, can I get some healing while we're flying, by the way?
Can I do something?
What? Healing? Sure.
I'm really hurt. Like, really, really hurt.
How about that? 14 HP. Okay. There you go. That should top you off.
Not really, no.
How about that?
Okay.
We're 37.
37, okay. That's pretty good.
That better?
Pretty good. It's getting there.
What, another one?
If you have one more, please.
Okay. There you go.
Thank 18. You.
I don't, you know. Then a Volnix can take one of those, two. That's like 14 HP. Does that do anything good for you?
I'm down by 13 now.
And then Einarvox can take six. And then I have a lot of my second level slots still. I don't use that many. Cause spiritual weapon kind of lasts for a long time. But I, you know, just in case we run into something, it's good to have something to do. And if we sleep, then they can, yeah.
Well, first of all, flying to the oasis as the sun does eventually show itself and light up the landscape. Einarvox is pretty sure that she spots a few vultures to the south.
Mm.
Circling over something or another.
Yeah, we should probably take a look.
Mm-hmm.
That means food.
Yep.
Or friends.
Food and friends.
If vultures are there, it means there's something
dead. Or dying.
Could roll if a knowledge flying, nature check.
If they're flying, they must be dying, because otherwise they would be eating it.
So,
right?
Guys, do you want me to just take 10 or...
Sure, that usually works. You can hit a 15 with a take 10, then.
I can hit with a knowledge of nature.
I don't like it. That basically mean you know most things about nature.
I can, no I matter can what kind 21.
Of thing it is. That knows a lot of things about all nature.
Yeah, looking at the group of vultures flying on the horizon, Einobox would think that it means one of two things. Either there's something currently dying, or there's something dead. And judging by the amount of vultures flying there, it must be something reasonably big.
Ooh.
Let's go and take a look.
Let's take a look. This is so exciting.
Yeah, lucky thing we flew here.
Would be essentially one hex to the south, a short trip. Not quite enough to tire you out completely yet, but a rest is necessary soon.
We'll go there, take a look, and then we can, like, if we don't like it, we can always go back to bathe and swim. Eat some vultures on the way, you know. I mean, they can learn to grill vulture. I'm sure you haven't tried that before.
Probably pretty stringy, you know.
Well, you can cook it. Long time cook it. We'll cook it here, and then it'll be done in the morning.
Slow cooked vulture. Yeah.
Pulled vulture.
Pulled vulture. Yep, we glide south.
And coming closer, you sooner or later at least get sight of what the vultures currently have been feasting on. There isn't much left of it, really, and the vultures scatter as you approach. What is undoubtedly the remains of a rather large creature half buried in the hot sand. Most of the body's flesh is completely eaten, the remaining dried up pieces completely swarming with translucent worms. And from the bones as well as scattered equipment, it is quite simple to tell that this is the body of a dragon. Scattered around, you see leather straps belonging to a harness, bottles, flasks with a number of differently colored liquids, as well as an undamaged and still half-filled barrel of water. A long trail of dragging footsteps extends some distance east. And almost entirely hidden by the quickly shifting sands in the area, around the large body of the dragon are dozens and dozens of dead aurochs, their skeletal remains showing signs, not of a fight, but definitely a slaughter. The color of the dragon is impossible to make out. The few bits of meat that still exist don't really have skin anymore. It would require a knowledge arcana to perhaps try to decide what kind of dragon it was from the bones.
I get a +2 to identifying dragons.
Yes.
So I will use that +2 too.
Well, I can't do much more than 2.
I'm pretty smart, as it happens.
Derp.
Rachax would think that this was most likely a copper dragon.
It looks like a copper dragon.
I know what agrees.
So, I agree.
Why?
What kind of liquids? Let's land and take a look.
So why would a copper dragon walk, like, in the desert?
Those copper dragons are kind of
stupid. Well, it was apparently packed up like a pack horse.
Yeah. Or did it bring this himself? Like, yes, I need to a barrel of water.
Well, you know...
It was walking east, so it was towards Sunta's land.
Einobox would actually think that it's weird, because copper dragons are supposed to be pretty smart.
It was coming from the east.
Oh, okay. It was going towards the oasis.
Maybe it was
probably
wounded and was running away.
Maybe it wanted to join us.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe it was going to give us all the aurochs, but it was kind of stupid anyway.
How big is it? Was it?
It's a large creature. Perhaps a little bigger than that.
What kind of... Is there any markings on the bottles?
The bottles are not marked, but the liquids are pretty distinct, and you would guess that they are magical potions.
I mean, are they still whole?
The bottles are still whole, yes.
So we'd take them all.
I didn't really use them.
Is there any... Maybe he died before he could. Is there any... Like, does he have a note, a diary?
Looking around the body, you do find a total of 5 potions. 4 different kinds. You do find a heavy leather-bound book.
Yes.
And in addition to that, you find large dragon-sized glasses.
Oh, copper dragon.
Aww. The glasses are definitely magical.
Super big glasses.
So when we, basically, when you take them up, they like resize to fit you.
Yes.
Oh my god, is this my birthday?
Well, let me identify them first. They might be like cursed glasses of never flying. I mean, it probably didn't work for this guy.
Cursed glasses of never flying. Yes, I do recall Sheep saying I was going to get that black market book, so that might be right, actually.
What?
It's not out yet, though. After the 21st, you have to be paranoid.
Yes, after that, we need to be very scared.
I mean, I have identified.
I like the idea of the glasses of non-flying. Such a weird item. Why did you...
I know who made them, because he was very afraid of suddenly falling into the sky.
He was very afraid of owls.
It's the glasses of grounding. He was afraid his ego would take off.
So, Mr. Eagle, would you please... He's like... Wah! Just flops to the ground. Like,
there we go. Done. Perfect.
Well, identify.
Well, I mean, it takes like 10 minutes. We do that when we get to the Oasis, right? Mm-hmm. Let's check out the book first.
The book is in surprisingly good condition, considering that the body is skeletal and must have been here for quite some time.
In that case, Tyraxus will hold the book so it doesn't break when Rakaix...
It only is as long as I touch it. It will not break as soon as I stop.
But if a book breaks, doesn't like all the pages fall out?
No, it just begins to warp weirdly. Like it begins to in Mass Effect when people do that warp ability around it, you see sort of reality sort of just twist and turn and look weird. That's
like,
what happens.
I don't like that.
Yeah. So when I touch it, it just begins to like weird like holes in it and then begins to twist in, like awkward angles and such. And then as soon as I stop touching, it's fine. As soon as I stop touching it,
interesting.
It'll be permanent in the future, but not for a long time.
Right.
Well, let's read the secrets of the book.
You read the book. The book, at first glance, is most definitely written in the easy-to-identify draconic runes of the draconic language. However, the words make little sense. It's an odd mixture of gibberish with the occasional half-written joke that lacks a punchline to a weird story about an uncolored dragon having an escapade with a copper pipe. It is very, very weird book.
Hmm.
There seems to be no sense to it.
Maybe it makes sense with the glasses.
Yeah, that seems likely.
Probably.
Even though it's been written in code.
Well, we bring the book.
Yeah.
Anything else here? I hear dragon bones kind of valuable.
There was a barrel of water.
We should find a guy. And scales and, you know.
We could be
suppliers.
There are certainly a lot of worms and bones.
Like, looking at a worm, like we pick up a worm, look at it, is it a special worm?
Like, what kind of fly would exist here that actually could find...
Corpse. He holds one out to Einabox. Can you take a look at this? Like, what is this worm?
Sure, what is it?
That would be knowledge nature.
Yeah, I'll just take 10 and it's 21.
With a 21, Einabox would be pretty sure that these worms really aren't supposed to be this resilient. The meat that is left is not the wet, icky meat that worms would thrive on. It is rather like it's completely dry from the sun, of course.
Okay, secretly thinks about what it tastes like.
These worms are most definitely out of place.
Did he have the worms when
are
he
left? Are the worms magical?
Good.
Is this an illusion?
Good roll. A will save to disbelief.
I will do that.
Secret will save.
I tried to set it to be secret.
Oh.
I did, but I can still see it.
Yeah, I attacked. So you can see your secret save, sorry.
Well, refusing to believe the bone has no effect.
Oh, okay.
Neither does it.
I was
it
trying
have...
to refuse the maggots, but sure.
The worms also are still there, even though you try to believe that they are not.
Try to pop one.
Okay.
I don't want to pop one.
I squeeze pop a worm.
Yeah.
Why would you want me to do it?
The worm pops.
Yeah.
To our checks, they are faintly magical.
They are faintly magical, as it turns out.
Are they the...
I kind of want to know what kind. Can I, like, use spellcraft to try and identify the kind of aura they might have?
Yes.
They probably have a jar somewhere. I can probably
are they the sickness that they've been talking about?
Maybe.
Oh, that would be a thing, wouldn't it?
You can't really identify where the worms come from, but you're pretty sure the type of aura... It's difficult to determine since the magic seems to be divine in nature.
This seems to be the work of a divine being.
Joseph frowns.
So,
do the worms seem to like be aggressive towards us?
Well, if they are, you can't really tell because they're worms and their aggression is pretty dumb. They are wiggling around, which might be an attack, or it might just be them wiggling around.
It frowns as we do know that there was a curse upon our kind. Could this be it?
That would explain why he's here dead.
Fleshworm infestations.
That's gross.
Tiamat frowns, looks over, what do you mean? I've never heard of this.
The dragon said so, didn't he?
Frowns, trying to remember. Did he?
He did not mention any kind of worms.
He said there was a plague. That had killed many of our kind.
So it was a sickness, didn't he?
Yes, a sickness. Magical divine worms. I mean, if they've been here for this long, then they are no spell that anyone I would know of could cast.
What type of worms are they?
What kind of answer are you looking for? I mean, they are
genus.
Worms. They are long, gooey,
slightly
translucent white things.
We want to categorize them in this chart we have.
No, are they native to this place or not?
No.
Where are they native to?
Einarbox wouldn't know.
But they don't seem to go back to the plains when you pop them, so they are here for good, which means they would have to be brought in here by quite some divine force, or created from scratch, but retain the divine residue.
We have a few jars and stuff, right? We can probably take a few with us if you want to study them.
I think one of you just...
Are there some empty bottles we could stuff some in?
Yes, there's at least one.
Oh, let's fill it with maggots.
All right, whatever. Fill it with maggots.
Then we can find out how long they live without, too.
Yeah.
Start up the experiments. Set up the alchemy lab. If we try to look over the skeleton, does it seem to be any obvious wounds? Like, oh, there's like a huge crush wound in the skull or anything like that.
You could roll me a heal check.
Let me help you with that.
I will tell you there's no obvious breaks in the bones that would indicate any sort of physical force.
Mm-hmm. This is the skull, that's the legs.
And Rachax, at least, is pretty damn sure that the aurochs scattered around here were killed by a large dragon, which presumably was this one.
Yeah, but the dragon don't seem to have been physically broken bones.
No.
It looks fine, but it certainly killed all the aurochs. Do the aurochs seem to have been running? Like, did he just sort of plop on them and just rip them apart? Did they fight, or...
The aurochs, there are signs that the aurochs have been running. There's about a dozen or so.
Just plopped down and killed like 12.
Yes.
Or he was
that
walking.
Is very much what it
he was
like.
Walking in the desert, sipping on his water bottle, reading with his glasses in his book, and these aurochs like charged him. You've seen what they do, and he's like,
yeah.
"Oh God!
I want your money, dragon?
Give us the fucking book, point, Dexter.
I'll take you with me." So he was walking then.
Mm-hmm.
And how could he run up aurochs, though? I don't know about you, but I'm not that fast.
Aurochs are fast.
No, they charged him.
No, it looks like he slaughtered them.
He
died from maggot infestation.
Yeah, he did. He did because they like were charging him because they want to stampede over him because that's what they do. And he breathes actually,
like,
and they
a
die.
Religion thing to know if this is the kind of thing that like spirits can do.
You could roll a religion.
Could be there's like the auric spirit.
I'm so sad now. This copper dragon walks over through the desert. He's sipping his water bottle and like reading his book. Just yes, very funny. Yes, and then like these orcs just trample over him. He's like, oh god, help!
Spirits, Rotax would know, rarely act through aurochs, at least.
It's probably not spirits who made this. They would most likely just make him have bad luck or something.
And also, it does look like the dragon has at least eaten some of the aurochs.
And the dragon did, you see here, this aurochs' leg is in the dragon's mouth. More likely, he ran them up, wallowed in the blood and just flipped around in it, then died.
I don't know.
Well, I mean, he would be walking. That means he is incapable of flying. Why else would you walk?
I still
would suggest that something was wrong with him to begin with. He was walking away from Sunta's lands, which means he's not trying to seek refuge there. It's very mysterious.
If Einavax couldn't have come back, I would have wanted her gravestone to say, Oryx are fast. Just to put that out there. I don't know.
There were big footsteps behind him, right?
Yes, big dragging footsteps.
Dragging. So he was limping at it.
I don't know he was limping.
Because he's dragging his legs across the ground.
No pun intended. Drag it.
No. Are you a copper now as well? Like, what is this?
It's contagious.
She read that in the book.
No, she read that in the book. She just takes
I'm
a
here,
giggle, like,
dragging my legs.
What a drag on.
None of the jokes in the book have a proper punchline.
She'll be gone a while.
Well, let's bring everything back to the oasis and we can study it in peace.
You can certainly do that, leaving the bones behind.
Poor dragon.
Poor dragon, poor us. Now I'm just making jokes all night.
Well, yeah.
A short time later, you can arrive at the oasis.
Oh. Get another tree. Yeah, so we hang out in the day, sleeping at the bottom of a lake. Oasis Lake, you know. Talking to cavefish, as you do.
The water being chilled by a Rolex who's sleeping right on the shore.
Yes, rest.
Your rest would essentially end in the afternoon, short before evening.
So, you know, let's try to identify those potions. And the glasses.
Roll me checks then. One for the potions should be enough. And one for the glasses.
Alright. I'll do it when I wake up, like in the evening. So I can use my my spell to give me +10. Yes, potions.
Is that enough?
And here we have for the glasses.
For the glasses, it's not enough. For the potions, however, that is enough, since they are just potions. You will have the following. I will paste it in chat. I've also marked the price for them for some reason, which you don't really need.
Why not?
I suppose.
You want to sell them.
If you want to sell them, here's the prices as well.
He didn't use either the cure wounds, the delay poisons, or the endure elements. Or were there a lot of broken bottles, you said, as well?
There was one bottle that looks to be a potion bottle that was used.
That's weird. Well, not very much we can do about it. Take his head back and claim we did it.
Well, I mean, we might as well. It's like morale boost, and then someone comes along, of course, and recognizes. Yeah. Is that my
friendly guard dragon?
Yeah, he's a friendly diplomat dragon that we sent out. You murdered him. War forever.
What did I miss?
I failed to identify the glasses. They're more magical than I thought.
Oh. And
potions. We just found out the potions. We're at the Oasis now, chilling.
Right.
Sleeping, resting, mm-hmm. bathing in the water.
Look at White trying. It's
certainly so cold.
Everyone is frolicking.
Also, just to make sure, I'm not sure if I mentioned it, Rachelix would think that the book is distinctly magical as well.
Yes.
Oh, can I do that as well?
You can try.
Sure, I'll do that.
It's one of those. It's one of those secret mage books. You know, we can put on the book.
Explosive runes.
Terrible. Yeah.
The book is certainly magical, and considering it hasn't exploded while reading, chances are it's supposed to be read somehow.
It is probably not going to explode.
It's symbol of death.
I will need another day or two to look at these things. They're,
sure.
They're powerful. We should not mess with
looking,
them.
Keep looking. Keep looking. Right. After the frolicking, I suppose we go for the general, right?
Sure. I mean, I guess that's what we would do, yeah. Should we go back first to like take a look and make sure that everyone's sort of like that they haven't just left again or something? Like last time something had happened, right?
I mean,
it's like you want to talk to your NPCs between every mission. They may just be calibrating, but you know, what if they have something to say?
Suddenly there's a glowy exclamation point over one of them. It's like, oh.
I think we should fly back first.
Okie doke.
What's up? We brought the flame tails in. Well, half of them. The other half is enslaved in Kermak.
Yeah. Can't do anything for them.
Not going to charge that place, though.
No.
What can you do?
Unless we do it with the Santa's name. Piss them off. And it's her. They probably wouldn't distinguish, though.
No. But it would be cool if they could send their, like, troll armies out to battle Santa.
I don't know anything about the place.
It's pretty bad.
Troll armies, though? Trolls? I mean, like, trolls?
They have. Pretty sure they have trolls in there.
Trolling you.
Oh, this we need another pyrohydra.
Have the pyrohydra. Chili Pepper the second.
The place we found Chili Pepper, it did state that there were multiple caves.
I don't think they live in packs though.
No, they're very solitary.
Maybe someone new has claimed the place.
Wait for a new pyrohydra to come waddling in.
Pyrohydra said, "This is a good place. I'm gonna live here."
Someone else did. Oh God, there was a yeah.
Another four dragons leap out with chains. It's like, get him! He's like, no! I just came to visit my great uncle Clarence.
Chili Pepper. He's dead?
No, Chili Pepper was the slave name we gave him.
You don't know. Maybe he had a sign that said, "Hello, my name is Chili Pepper."
I don't think he had that, no. Well, it was not like Winnie the Pooh, who had like a sign outside his.
So, I suppose we go to the old Flame Tails camp and hang out by that oasis, like, until we tomorrow fly there, right? Because we can't fly the whole distance one time, and I don't want to stay and, like be grilled. That's not a pleasant thing.
You don't like being grilled, no. I get it.
No.
Going back home does essentially take 2 days. You have enough leniency to essentially be able to decide at which time of the day you want to arrive, though.
I mean, you know, morning, generally. The time where people are most relaxed.
Morning, you say.
Can I get fully healed by then?
Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna land with a thunderous
can I do
buffeting
a, can
of
I
wings
do another set of identifications then?
Yes.
I'd like to do that then. Alright, good. I'll roll three. Well, actually two. Which is glasses and then book. That's
the
better.
The glasses you now realize are glasses of detection. They work as the lens of detection, giving the wearer a +5 competence bonus on perception checks, as well as a +5 competence bonus on survival checks when tracking.
That's very nice.
It's like a rise.
Let me check the book then.
Oh my god, they am. That would make Anavax so cool.
I have no problem with Anavax taking those classes.
The book is probably simply a magically encrypted journal.
Hmm. Well, can I magically unencrypt it?
The researchers would think that that would be very, very difficult. Not impossible, but difficult. The easiest way would be to find the code word or code phrase, which could be done by studying the contents of the book in its encrypted form.
Can't sure.
Einavox have the glasses?
I'm okay with it. If I have glasses, I want them to be like spellcraft or something.
Well, she uses perception of survival a lot.
Yeah, she does track. Any of you guys have a gripe with it?
I guess not. I mean, they're very pricey, but sure.
They are 1,000 gold.
There are 3,500, aren't they?
Well, yeah, but we'd sell them for 1,000.
Studying the book would be linguistics.
Then I'll yoink them.
I can study the book then. I'm not super good at it, but...
Where is your token? That's a good question. It's gone.
Linguistics.
Let me check.
14 would be enough, I'm sure.
No. 14 would not be enough. DDS, your token is gone. You must have deleted it or something.
You're the one moving the tokens around.
I didn't move it back to the map. That was you guys.
It's probably about to get swallowed up in the darkness.
Maybe it's still on the... Yeah.
Why did you come back to us?
Where's the Volnix?
I am thinking that there's no Avulnix token on this map.
And we find him in a desert with maggots crawling out of him.
Like, oh!
Except his eyeballs are still there and it looks at you and then like a maggot is out of it.
Ew.
And he's like, help me!
You are the one, the next one to access. Oh, it's you!
Oh, God.
Come with you!
This is what Laura thinks happened.
You turn around and suddenly you hear the shatter. You dropped the glass. And now you don't see any maggots anywhere. Where have they gone?
Sunta used the white dragon orb and he's gone. It's like, oh, well.
And ordered Avonix to delete himself.
Mm-hmm. Oh, come over here now.
Well, I have...
I didn't touch my token during the conversation.
I didn't delete it.
I command you all to borrow. Just put on a local copy.